Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to be going over how you can edit your Vidcast. So to get to the editor's panel where all of our editing tools reside, you simply come here to edit. And the first thing you will be taken to are your video details. So here we can see you can edit your title, your description. Once highlights do go live, they could be live right now, but want to be mindful that they're not quite live as I'm recording this video. But you can edit your highlights. So those summaries within your video, whether it's the duration, the text, adding, playing all of them, or even deleting the highlights, you can do everything there. And you can even edit your chapters here as well. Those are generated by AI as well. So if you do need to edit those, delete, add, whatever it might be, you can do so there. And then even add tags and change the default playback speed. Now, if we come over here to select thumbnail, this is where you can click and drag and choose a different thumbnail based on the frames within your video. If we come down to stitch, this is where you can combine or stitch your videos together into one video, and you can click the plus mark, select one or multiple videos here, whether they're WebEx meeting imports that you have uploaded, videos you've recorded directly within the tool. This allows you to select any of those, add selected. And from here, you can click and drag, reorganize whatever order you want that video to be in, and you can save. Now, as a best practice, for any time you're editing your video, highly recommend you saving the video as a new clip, because if you save the video, that will just save as the original, and that unedited version will no longer exist. So when in doubt, always save video as a new clip so you can maintain that raw, unedited video in its original form, and then you will also have the edited video as well. All right, and then you can also trim your video. So to do that, you simply click and drag to wherever you want the video to end, click and drag to wherever you want the video to begin, and anything within this giant yellow rectangle will be kept for your video. And now if we go to clip, clip allows you to remove from the middle of your video. So you select where you want the clip to be removed. You can drag, make it bigger, smaller, and even clip up to 3 segments at a time. Now anything within this rectangle will be removed from your Vidcast. So I just want to say that again because it is a bit different than trim. Anything within this rectangle will be removed from your Vidcast. Now we can talk about our Slido polls. You can embed a Slido poll directly within your Vidcast today. So as you can see, I already have one in here, but super easy to add another one. We click wherever we want that poll to come up, and we can select between multiple choice, open text, rating, and even a word cloud. And once you have that, we can say, how can you see yourself using Vidcast? Awesome, and create. And you can see within just a second, that poll has been created. And once you press finish, that will now come up at that point in time for all of your viewers, for them to fill out, and you as the creator to get that instant asynchronous feedback. And if you want to delete, you just click on that poll, select delete, and that will be deleted. And then, of course, you can also edit your transcript. So wherever you want to edit, you can click into there, replace it with whatever you want to replace it with. And once you press confirm, that will be updated in both the transcript and the closed captions. Last but not least, if you want to invite somebody to edit your video, you can come up here in the upper right-hand corner. And just like it is with our share permissions, you can see this comes up. And let's delete one just so I can show you how we added him in the first place. You come here just like you're going to share your video with someone. You type their email address and you then can select, you can either click the person or select share. Once you select share, they will come up here and by default, they will be a viewer. You come down to the dropdown, select editor, and when you press done, they will get a notification in both their email and an in-app notification letting them know that they have been designated as an editor for this video. They will have access to around 90% of all the features that you being the creator currently do, but they will not be able to delete your video because they are not the owner of that video. All right, those are the editing tools that we have within Vidcast. Check out the last video, which is the video that I talk about how you can discover videos within your organization.